Pekka Rati of Finland gets the bronze, exactly the same three medalists as 4 years ago.
Well, the heat is really on in the 5,000 meters as they come round with just over six to go. Nyariki, the Kenyan, has made a really bold bid from a long, long way out to take it off. Kararia in second place. Bob Kennedy, America, is third. Then Beatok, the Kenyan. Three Kenyans are the first four. Segeer of Morocco, fourth in the World Championship next. Niangabo from Burundi, not showing at all. Lalapi just behind him. And Balami. Baeza and Baumann, the reigning champions from Germany there. De Napoli just behind him, and Alina of Spain. And this lot breaking away, 3, 6, 9, 12. And really, the leader is trying to work his way through and hurt the rest.
A little bit surprised that Nyariki of the Kenyans actually went that quickly, because he is a very good sprinter. But he's that lap there he ran was just over 61 seconds, and now he's giving a turn to his mate Kororia. So the team plan for the Kenyans is that Kororia and Nyariki are going to share the lead, and Beatok, the Olympic silver medalist from last time around, in fourth place there, has been away from the lead altogether, not had to do any of the pacemaking, not interested in doing any of the pacemaking, and he's a fantastic sprinter, is Beatok. They come up off 3,000 meters in 8 minutes. Well, I didn't expect the pace to be exceptionally fast, and 8 minutes of 3,000 meters isn't exceptionally fast.
The crowd roaring for the man in second place, Bob Kennedy. Prepared to live with the Africans to take them on. The only non-African ever to break 13 minutes. He's in second place. He's strong, he's hard. But what's the man in fourth place, Niangabo? And what's Beatok? Beatok is wearing 1790.
Well, Bob Kennedy said he's got used to running with Africans around him. Well, today, he's certainly got that opportunity, because there are nine Africans all around him, all in that leading group, and then Dieter Baumann at the back of the group. And Bob Kennedy says he's been thinking about training with them. He's trained with them in London. He's learning a lot from them. He's not overawed by them. And if the pace is not too hard, he thinks he's going to make a long run for home. And he'll try and win this race, he said to me yesterday. Whether I do it or not, I'm not sure. I really don't care, as long as I give myself a chance. Because on the last lap, there are too many sprinters, too much talent for me to handle. Now, will Bob Kennedy give it a shot here? Moving down the back straight, beginning to think about taking over the lead, I'm sure. As Kororia, the Kenyan, leads, and up comes the other Kenyan, who's been sharing the pace with him. And Bob Kennedy follows, and now Nyariki leading again, and the first time has shown near the front in second place there, Venuste Niangabo, who had the choice between the 1500 meters, where he's one of the top three in the world, and this 5000 meters. Was it a wise choice? Things aren't going against him so far. It's beginning to go his way, and Dieter Baumann still in that group, just on the back of the group, but in amongst it.
Baumann, the reigning Olympic champion, come round now with three to go. Nyariki leads, Niangabo second, Kennedy third, Beatok four, Kororia five, Segeer in sixth place, Balami is seven, and they're gathering. De Napoli is the first finisher from Italy. Will they run a finish out of him in the blue vest next to Bath? But Nyariki pushing hard in front. And there's always tribal differences with the Kenyans, but they seem to come here as a team in the 10,000 meters and the 5,000. And it seems to be working as well. Lalapi now, Morocco coming over the outside. One of three Moroccans in this final.
Well, the Kenyans certainly have run as a team in this race. Just through 4,000 meters, 10 minutes and 40 seconds. And I'll be very interested to see what the last 1,000 meters is going to be. But the race is being run by the Kenyans to help Paul Beatok improve on his silver medal from Barcelona. See if he can win gold today. He's on the inside in third place, and he's exceptionally fast. And now Kennedy trying to do what he told me he was going to do and have a go with this race. Niangabo's in the lead now. That's the first time he's at the front, and he's got a very good strong finish. But there goes Bob Kennedy, and the stadium absolutely erupts.
The crowd love it. 83,000 in here. And Kennedy leads. He's gone for it with 800 meters to go. But he's been hunted by the Africans. And Beetok is right there now in third place. Nian Garbo in second place.
And the two dangers to Bob Kennedy are on his shoulder. Here comes Venisti, Nian Garbo, the miler moved up. Here comes Nairiki, the former sprinter from Kenya. And on the inside, Paul Beetok. He's run a very, very quiet race, but he's there right in the position. And there the Moroccan moving through in the second place. But here comes the reigning champion, Dieter Baumann, in four.
Well, Nian Garbo's made the break. Baumann's a fast finisher, but he's back in fourth. Bob Kennedy made the bid. It hasn't worked. The Moroccan there is Bellamy. So Nian Garbo has gone for home. He's the quickest 1500 meter run in the field. And I would say this is a gold medal run. Less than 200 to go. It's now about silver and bronze. Beetok have got the silver 4 years ago. Bellamy is there. Baumann, the gold medalist of 4 years ago. But Nian Garbo of Burundi is going to take their first ever gold medal in the Olympic Games. Nian Garbo wins. Beetok is second. Third place was Bellamy. Fourth was Baumann. Nairiki was in fifth place. Bob Kennedy died a little bit, was possibly sixth. The winning time, 13.07.97. De Napoli, well, he's a fast finisher, but at this level, he couldn't stay with him. The sustained pace was enough. And what a good decision by this man, not to take on Morsley in the 1500, but to go for the 5000. He came here with only two career 5,000 meters before the Games. But he made the right choice. He is the Olympic champion.
He certainly did make the right choice. And there, Nian Garbo stretching them. Bellamy begins the chase. Dieter Baumann in fourth place, maybe sensing there was a medal there for him. And Paul Beetok, the silver medalist from Barcelona, down the back straight. And Nian Garbo is now sprinting like the 1500 meter runner that he is. The race really now is on for second and third. Baumann thinks he can do it, but Nian Garbo has shown them all a clean pair of heels. Bellamy run a great race in second place. Beetok in third now. And at that point, I sensed that Nick Dieter Baumann would have a chance here. He moved onto the outside. Beetok starts his sprint a bit early. And the three of them are closing down on Nian Garbo. Nian Garbo's made his effort. It always looked like a winning lead down the back straight, but they're closing on him slightly. He's tiring, and Bellamy's determined to hold off the former champion. That was his last run. He ran the finish out of Dieter Baumann, and the result, Nian Garbo, Paul Beetok silver again, and in third place, Bellamy, and the reigning champion has to settle for fourth as a new champion, the first Burundian athlete to win a gold medal. Always the talent of this race. The race was run to suit Beetok by the other two Kenyans, but eventually the race suited Venusti Nian Garbo. And look at the determination on Dieter Baumann's face. The first European finishing in fourth place, and the Africans 1, 2, and 3.
So, Nian Garbo wins it. And impressively, 13.07.97, the unofficial winning time. Beetok gets his second silver medal. Bellamy in third place for Morocco. And that's the way they finished. The top non-African was Dieter Baumann, the reigning Olympic champion, in fourth place. Just not far behind him was Bob Kennedy in sixth. Nian Garbo, Beetok, and Bellamy, the medalists.